Vedic astrology. This Papa Samai Dosha is very, very important for pre and post marriage session analysis actually. This Papa Samai Dosha, if you go, you can analyze 60-70% of person capability, personalities and attitude and everything. If you take afflictions, take two afflictions, Jupiter and Saturn afflictions, that is more than enough to analyze Vedic astrology. Next, the Drishti. Drishti part, B.V. Raman has given more than lot of information in Drishti. Then, the Ramu Keta Dosha. Ramu Keta Kalasarpa Dosha is 6 Dosha, 1728. Like that, the 6th pattern of Kalasarpa Dosha is very, very important. Then Viparita Raja Yoga, with 9 planets, there are more Viparita Raja Yogas in Vedic astrology. It is a ocean subject again. Then Muhurta Lagna. In Muhurta Lagna, 21 points are very, very important. Muhurta Lagna, one Muhurta Lagna, you have to fix with the 21 important events is very, very important. And then Mahadasas. Mahadasas, 6 planets only Mahadasas. That is Guru, Guru, Shani, Venus, like that. 6 planets is giving a Mahadasas. Study of Mahadasas takes more than time actually. Then Ashtagarga. Ashtagarga, there is no Ashtagarga for Rahu and Ketu. Only Surya, Chandra, Guru, Shukra, like that. 7 planets covering Ashtagarga. The Arishta Dosha. Arishta Dosha is nothing but Bala Arishta. Bala Arishta up to 4 years. Mother Bala Arishta is very important. Up to 8 years. Father Dosha is very important. Up to 12 years, the particular native Dosha is very important. And then Madhino Ayush, Dirga Ayush, like that, it is Arishta Doshas. Arishta Dosha is very important. Then Saturn Dosha. Saturn Dosha is very important. Like Sare Sati. Sare Sati is very important because Saturn giving a lot of doshas. If you take a Punarpu Dosha, Chandra and Shani, the Punarpu Dosha is creating a very, very magnetic reaction after marriage, actually. Like that. So, if Shani, anyone wants to worship, there are plenty of things people say, but in Skanda Purana, Om Sham Shanishwaraya Nama, there is the only thing in Skanda Purana is recommending. The Skanda Purana is exclusive of 18 Puranas. Otherwise, the only person, Shani, he worshipped Prasanna Chakravarti is worshipped as Shani. He says, Asya Sri Shani Saraswata Mahamantrasya Kashava Rishi Anushtupta Mantagata. Like that, if you worship with Shani, with Karanjasa and Karanjasa, Shani gives some sort of relief in Sare Sati time actually. Then, Manglik Dosha. Manglik Dosha is Mars related. Manglik Dosha, so many people say so many things, but it's only 50 to 20 types of cancellation process in Manglik Dosha. All these are already Vedic astrology information. Then Down syndrome, genetic astrology. Genetic astrology is based on only 5 Panchamaga Purusha Yogas. Based on only 5 planets actually. Again, 5 planets are Venus, Guru, Shukra, and Mark, like that. These 5 planets are very important in the genetic astrology. The genetic astrology, if you say genetic chemistry, one of the important things. That means first children and second children, the genetic chemistry will be different actually. So the genetic astrology is also part of the Vedic astrology, but it is a version actually. The synastry is a blended with Western and Vedic astrology. This is a relationship with the male and female relationship. It's a boyhood relationship, it's a affair relationship, it's an illegal relationship, it's a post-marital affair relationship. The synastry is reflecting those type of relationships. And if you go with New Year astrology is what? Just King, Raja, Mantri, Senadhipati, apart from the Shashadhipati, Angadhipati, Mogadhipati, Nirashadhipati, like that we can calculate in New Year astrology. In Karnataka it is Yugadi, Tamil Nadu it is Budu Varsha, in Kerala it is Vishu, and Maharashtra it is Gudi Padwa. Like that, this New Year astrology, we can predict based on Vedic astrology. Vanashastra is very, very big subject, because Vanashastra, you must know, it's few information about Vanashastra, not entire thing. Vanashastra is part of that thing. Haridra Chakra is for a monsoon calculation. It's a very mathematical calculation. From sun starting from Katkarasi to Dhanur Rashi, this monsoon related monsoon, all rainfall and other things. This Haritha Chakra is giving complete information in the astrology. And eclipse, you know, the solar eclipse, lunar eclipse are there. Last 3 years we have not come across solar eclipse in full solar eclipse. Because we have received a partial solar eclipse. With the partial solar eclipse, not happened. The monsoon is not clear. That means we never get the full rainfall. We never get otherwise we get high cool or very hot like that. It's a very, very complicated. If there is no solar eclipse, our weather not give proper things. These things also you can calculate in the Vedic astrology. Again, ions are related to climate time. India is a +5.3, Pakistan is 5, and again Bangladesh is like that. It is ions are central climate. Central climate is nothing but it's a 21 degrees a slanting position of information. All this comes in the ions are. And we call it as here, we follow two panchangas. One is a Vakya Panchanga and Ganita Panchanga. What is different between Vakya? Vakya Panchanga is ancient Panchanga. Ganita Panchanga is recently found out. Ganita Panchanga and Vakya Panchanga. Sunny 50 to 60 degrees, 50 days difference for transit time. Jupiter is 30 to 40 days different transit time. Other planets are days are different. I think in Vedic astrology we have to follow these two panchanga, because Ganita gives in degree and nimisha. Vakya is giving in pada, gati, nadiya, like that it is going on. Then Komet. Komet is very, very important. The Komet study is a very big equation in Vedic astrology. If you know Vanasastra, some part of Vanasastra, you can give Komet. Komet we cannot predict immediately that it occurs. But some clues are there. Komet has a big tail, Komet has a big head. Like that depends on the Komet that the magnetic reactions are created in the universe. And finally, commerce. With commerce, we can calculate GDP. GDP is the Adaya and the Nashtada calculation. We can calculate with the GDP. And crude oil. Crude oil is, we can see after Sankaranti, crude oil prices will go off actually, because Saturn has come out from the Vrishika Rasi. And now the conjunction of Surya, Saturn, Venus gives the crude oil high. And after Sankaranti, the crude oil goes normal. Like that, we can calculate bullion market, gold. And stock exchanges of NSE, BSE. See, these 20 events are related to Vedic astrology. Why I have to give this information means Vedic astrology is not single book and single event. It is a multiple event and cluster of information. We have to study endless information in Vedic astrology. I have cited nearly 20 events in Vedic astrology. And we are going to see only one event in Vedic astrology. That is Papasamai Dosha. That is Papasamai Dosha. Before that Papasamai Dosha, star matching is very, very important. There are plenty of conflict in the star matching. So the next screen will inform the matching. See, the South Indian and North Indians are following various systems actually. If you say Vasan Panchanga 12 matching, Arkad Panchanga 12 matching, Vakya Panchanga and Ganita, here in Karnataka most of them are following Ganita, because Sringeri Math is following Ganita Panchanga. Here, so Ganita system is followed. And then PSIR, BV Raman, like go where the varieties are not matching, 12 to 32. So this star matching is very, very important before going for a matrimonial assessment. Yeah, that's right. And we are going to now see Papasamai Dosha. What are all the parts of Papasamai Dosha that creates a post and pre-marital process? One minute, the Papasamai Dosha, where it is originated is very important, because Papasamai Dosha is not only with a particular planet, it is a cluster of planet creating the Papasamai Dosha. And apart from that, Papasamai Dosha is not Mangali. This is a very, very huge information. And Papa Samai, mostly the Papa Samai Dosha is forms which are Krishna Paksha Chandra. Krishna Paksha Chandra is next way. Krishna Paksha Chandra is from Purnima to Amavasya, moon crossing days, the 15 days. The Papa Samai, Krishna Paksha Chandra creates mostly the Papa Samai Dosha. What are all the planets involved in Papa Samai Dosha? That we will discuss now. Please. In Papa Samai Dosha, along with the Krishna Paksha Chandra, Saturn, Mars, Rahu Ketu, Venus, all these are all planets created Papa Samai Dosha. Next. Now, with the Krishna Paksha Chandra, moon, here you have read carefully, because here I displayed ascendant. Moon from ascendant 2, 4, 7, 8 create 1 point Papa Chandra. Because Papa Samai Dosha has scores that you have to watch very carefully. The next screen will be different. Next is not ascendant. Next screen is a moon from Saturn. Saturn is 2, 4, 7, 8 creates half point, I think. You have to note this point very carefully. Next. Then again Mars. From Moon, Mars stands 2, 4, 7, 8, 12. This creates again half point Papa Samai Dosha. Next. Then Rahu Ketu. Rahu Ketu creates from Moon 2, 4, 7, 8, 12 is a half point Papa Samai Dosha. This you have to be careful, very, very careful. You have to note down list of the Papa Samai Dosha point. Next. Then Venus creates again 2, 4, 7, 8, same position. This is 0.25 points of Papa Samai Dosha. That is the index. Again, the total calculation we have to come out and derive for sheet. Next. Now I have calculated some part of Papa Samai Dosha for May. It's a 3.25 points. Then now we are going to calculate next. Now we are going to calculate for female. Like that, we have to calculate for female. What are the from ascendant Mars, Moon, Venus, female? So, for female, I have calculated various Papa Samai Dosha. It comes around 3. Now, what we should do? The female Papa Samai Dosha and the male Papa Samai Dosha, we have to analyze the present terms of studies in Vedic astrology. The healthy way of matching, female should be 3, male should be 3.25. This is the healthy way of Papa Samai Dosha, because male Papa Samai Dosha is high, is no problem. But female Papa Samai Dosha should not be high, comparing to male. This is healthy Papa Samai Dosha change. See, this should not be there, female 3 points or male, that is male 3 points, female 3 points, because the female has a reproductive organ, that means she carries the baby, she delivers for the next generation. So that is why male should be always up and female should be down. So 3.5 is male and 3 is male and 3.5 is an unhealthy sign of matching of Papa Samai Dosha in Vedic astrology. We'll see some more along with Papa Samai Dosha, we have to go other doshas in the Vedic astrology, because we are matching for a matrimonial purpose. We have to choose other doshas also. Next. See, everyone knows the Mangalik dosha, but North India, what they do, only 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 12. But South India, in Tamil Nadu, 1 also, 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 12. Like that we calculate for a Mangalik dosha. Next. Then, this Amavasya dosha, this is Amavasya affliction. Here, only female, that Amavasya born of female should not, that means the malefic position should not, the Saturn, Sun and Moon should not be in the malefic position. That creates a deep affliction, because more and more affliction goes in karmic affliction. That should not occur in a female. Next. Again, this affliction, Saturn and Mars affliction, is very, very complicated. After, that means post-marriage, after marriage, this creates a lot of problem. Next. Again, Sun-Venus combination also in 2, 5, 7, 9. Sun-Venus combination in any house, for ladies it's a hormonal imbalance, for gents it's a less sperm count. This is like a actually. Okay, next. Well, that means this is very, very another drawback. Saturn and Mercury together in 579, it creates a progeny. That means progeny means issues. The children's delay or children's of a low educated mind like that, it creates, because Saturn and Mercury are neutral gender planets. So this should not have, this not have either male characteristics or female characteristics. That is why this combination, mainly in fifth house, it creates a lot of problem actually. Next. Again, Sun and Saturn, mostly it is Pitru Dosha. Pitru Dosha is this combination of Dosha. This also creates a lot of problem. For this problem, we have to go Rameshwaram, 15 days in Malayama. That means Pitru Paksha is 15 days. We have to go and sit, perform Tarpana for our ancestors. Then I think somewhat it gives a relief. Or else yearly you have to fund 91 tarpanas, but we do only 60 to 80 tarpanas. But yearly, if you do 91 tarpana, this Pitru Dosha will be cleared. Again, Saturn Moon. This is very, very complicated, because Saturn and Moon combination gives Punarpudosh. Punarpudosh means post-marital issues. Post-marital issues, what happened after marriage, both should not have anyona sagaya, that means anyona sagaya is less. And both of them will be, every day the conflict goes off actually. This Punarpudosha, I have seen in only place in Chennai, Ambattur, really, that one particular patta is performing remedial homa and puja. So this Punarpudosha is very, very important. But only the thing is, we have to see the strong guru. 5, 7, either if female has Punarpudosha, male should be having a 5, 7, 9 Jupiter. Or if male is having the Punarpudosha, female should have a 5, 7, 9 Jupiter. This is the very, very nearest remedial for that actually. Next. Saturn should not occupy Vrishika and Mesha in 7th house. Not everywhere I am talking. Because Satan, Vrishika and Mesha gives mostly 70% malefic reaction, because Saturn and Mars are not a cardial relationship. We have seen last 3 years, Saturn was in the Vrishika Rasi. They created lot of problem in the universal. So now it has come. That means Saturn never gives easily result when he sits in the Vrishika Rasi or Mesha Rasi. That is the only problem. It should not be 7th house for anyone actually. Again, this morning two people have spoken about the Sannyasa Yoga. Here, I mean, Vedic Astrology, I say, the Sannyasa Yoga, these 5 planets, Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Venus, Mercury, combination should not occupy this 2, 5, 7. Why it is 2, 5, 7? Actually, Sannyasa is in Indian Hinduism. It is Dvaita, that is Dvaita, Advaita, Vashishta Dvaita. Dvaita, Advaita, Vashishta Dvaita, what they say, Sannyasa. Dvaita and Vashishta Dvaita, they are accepting Grihastasrama, after Grihastasrama Sannyasa. Advaita is never accepting after Grihastasrama Sannyasa. Only at the age of before 10, Advaita is only advised to go for Sannyasa Yoga. So again, this Sannyasa Yoga, Ekadanda Sannyasa, Vidanda Sannyasa Yoga, there are plenty of Sannyasa Yoga. But we see only astrological point of. See, if any planet, this Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Venus, Mercury, should occupy 2, 5, 7, 9, what happened? It's Graha Yuddha. Graha Yuddha comes. Again, your post-marital life is not good. Again, every day you sit alone, or you travel for pilgrimage, or you go for some places to take rest like that. You know, the husband and wife relationship is not good. That is called a Sannyasa Yoga here. There are plenty of Sannyasa Yoga, we have to describe so many. But astrological Sannyasa Yoga, the 3 planets, any of the 5, 3 planets occupy in 2, 5, 7, 9, it gives trouble in after marriage actually. That is not very important. Again. See, the 7th house Jupiter, only I am talking about this Makar Rasi Jupiter, should not be in a 7th house, 7th place actually. Because why the depletion, once Jupiter depletion, what happened, again progeny issues happen. That means the next generation is very, very difficult. So only this is the point I'm marking out the Jupiter in seventh house Makara Rasi. Next. Again, these are all the difficulties. Nabin Shab Dosha, Pavasamai Dosha, General Dosha, if you calculate, you have to measure these things. Once you measure this, 70% of your chart will be analyzed. And the post-marriage will be very easy. Only 30-40% problems you can come over easily. This seventh house sun, what gives now? In the middle age, that means 30-45, a lady goes for separation, divorce. She goes for divorce or separation. Because sun is agitation mode. She never accepts anything that doesn't happen. So in the middle age, the triggers goes up. So she always goes for legal separation. Most of the chart I have seen, they are in separation, they are living separately, or they are after legal separation. Like that, the sun is in 7th house actually. And this K2 Mars. This K2 Mars at 12th house is what it creates, Sayana Yoga. Both are together, not sleep in a single room. Husband may be traveling various places, wife will be in the house. Sometimes wife goes to mother house. Like that, the K2 and Mars, Mars create Manglik Yoga, K2 create. That's why together is not possible, both of them, if Mars and K2 in 12th house. These are all indicating the points. Well, that means at the time of pre-matrimonial analysis, if you check with any astrologer, you can skip the area. Next. And again, I have seen the K2 Dasha after marriage, 1 year, 6 months, if K2 Dasha comes, the lady should not live together with the husband. I have seen most of the time, in the mother's house, or separately she's living, if she's living, separately living. Like that, the Ketu Dasha is for Jnana Moksha Karaka, he is not for a material life, and he is not for a together livingness. That is very, very problem. Next. And in South India, this is very, that means Tamil Nadu, this is very, very important. A girl after 12 years, 10 to 12 years, she is attending a puberty. Again, that 2, 5, 7, 8, 9 houses should not be affliction or dosha. Okay. Again, if you see this is before in matrimonial process, Sri Jataka given very, very important. Because Sri Jataka is a few houses, Sri Jataka is a special type of analysis we have to go. What are the special type of analysis? Fourth house should not carry Shatan. I told Pulapu Dosha. Again, fourth house, Sun Moon, is not is Amavasya Dosha. Then Saturn Mars, no. The Sun Venus, it is a progeny issue. Then Sun Buddha, it is again progeny issue. The fourth house is for ladies should be before pre-matrimonial analysis, very, very important. Next. Because of the fourth house issues, see, I have listed out so many items. I think it's related to ladies' situation. You can read it on the screen itself. So all this problem, all this hormonal imbalances are occurring because of fourth house. What are the hormonal imbalances? If you say, after 13 years puberty creates issues for at the time of delivery, it creates because her hormonal imbalance never allows to go normal delivery system. Like that COD, monthly fibroid is another issue for delay progeny. And fallopian tube black, if there are two fallopian tubes, there is one is okay, she can deliver the child. Like the COD, the monthly cycling, some female have 28. The COD cycling problem is with that. If lady is a dancer or sports, again, she'll be having a progeny issue. Then egg fertility capability. Everything goes normal, but female egg is not capable to fertilize with the male egg. That is also one problem related to fourth. The temperature under uterus again. Folic acid is irregular. If you take a daily one apple, the folic acid imbalance will be clear. Like that, there are still more and more problems with respect to fourth house hormonal balance of women. Actually, here we have to say one particular thing. Here now, UTF, there are karma fact, private karma factors are now come. That means UTF related medical treatment. You can go for progeny, easy progeny things. Artificial insemination, it is called artificial insemination. And with this UTF, you can avoid hereditary diseases, and they purify the sperm and egg, there won't be any hereditary disease that comes. So the fourth house should be very, very clear for women. This is very important. With that, that means why I am citing this much problem in Papa Samai Dosha along with other Dosha means. At the time of marriage, people say, eight matches is there, you can go for marriage. That should not be there. We have to calculate all these things. If you calculate this, 60 to 70% of analysis will be over pre-matrimonial analysis. Then Papa Samai Dosha is clear. That means if you have a correct information, later stage you can avoid lot of conflict surgery. With that, I will come to the conclusion of my lecture. I thank you very much for Sandhya Shekhar, giving me this opportunity.